how do we communicate NMR data to people within the field? So this is a formatting issue. And as it turns out, the way we do it is described right on this line. We report the chemical shift. That's a value that's in ppm. That's our x-axis value for our peak. And then in parentheses, we say how many hydrogens do we have. Then a comma, what's the multiplicity? And then lastly, the J value in hertz, if it has a J value. So if something is a singlet, S, there is no J value. So what is the chemical shift? If you have a peak that looks like, here's a quartet I'm trying to sketch out, the position of the peak is the dead center point of the peak. Now, for a quartet, that means you're going in between the two peaks. But in something like a triplet, the center point of this peak happens to be on the largest peak. So it's a single ppm value. The number of hydrogens is simply the integration. The multiplicity is its multiplicity. Is it a singlet? Is it a doublet? Of course, this can include more complex things. Multiplicity is typically one letter. So a singlet would be S. A doublet equals D. Triplet is T. Quartet is Q. That's an ugly Q, but you get the idea. And then, of course, you can have complex multiplicities like DD for doublet of doublets or DT for doublet of triplets. If you have a DD or DT, you're saying there are two separate coupling constants, so you will report two separate J values. What is one exception? Sometimes in a peak, you have multiple peaks that kind of overlap. This is not that uncommon. And you look at that and you say, is that a doublet? Is it a bunch of triplets? I don't know. In that case, if you don't know, you call it a multiplet. What does multiplet means? Multiplet means I don't know. You're surrendering, wave the white flag. And you simply abbreviate that as M. What is the chemical shift for a multiplet? Well, since there is no real center to this peak, you simply say, well, the multiplet starts here and it ends there. So you report a range of shift values. That multiplet runs from 7.42 to 7.29. So a multiplet is a range where the peaks show up. Now for the full spectrum, you report all your peaks. So this is one signal right here. And before you preface it and say, what it's an NMR spectrum. What kind of NMR? Well, it's proton NMR. You report the field strength of your magnet. And you ought to report what solvent you used to acquire the spectrum, what you dissolved the sample in. If you change the solvent, that might change the position of the peaks a little bit, and that needs to be, so reporting the solvent is an important detail. Now, as it turns out, and the NMR database, NMRDB, does a really good job of showing this. And as you can see here in the middle of the screen, there is... it actually gives all the data in exactly the format that I mentioned. Now, since these aren't this isn't an experimental spectrum, it doesn't include, with NMR, it doesn't report what is the field strength of the magnet or the solvent used, because there was no solvent used. It was a simulated spectrum. Still, the NMR DB actually reports in exactly this format, and this is the format that almost all journals use for reporting your NMR characterization data in organic chemistry.